Okay, I guess we can start. Hi everyone, good afternoon, good evening. This is Naveen Joshua from Green Ventures. I'm excited to host such a strong set of industry experts and panelists over the next hour to better understand views and strategies in post-COVID times, primarily discussions around preparedness for the undeniable new normal in retail, which would seem to be fast moving in the tech and digital direction, probably in terms of enablement. The good thing is the experience of our speakers today covers apparel, footwear, home furnishing, baby care, and across all consumption segments as well, men, women, kids. So looking forward to our attendees taking away valuable insights over the next hour. A quick note on the format: approximately 40 odd minutes of panel discussion, and then we'll open up for 15 minutes of about Q&A. You can send in your questions, as I see you've already started doing that in the Q&A section. The bottom of your screen is a button. And just in case you miss out on any part, don't worry, we'll have a recording of the webinar shared with you shortly, just in case. So if I'm clear, I can just proceed with a quick introduction. I'd like to use that for all of our speakers. So the first introduction, more so in alphabetical order rather than anything else, Abhinav Mahajan, Director Retail at Masper. Past 15 years handling business planning, in-store, online strategy, market and channel development. So I would also like to say that Mahajan Overseas completed 50 glorious years last year. And the brand Masper, which was launched in 2002, has spread its presence in global markets as well. Abhinav, would you like to please join in and make that introduction better than I could have?
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Abhinav, and I am representing my brand called Masper. We've been in the home furnishing space since 1969, primarily into manufacturing and exports based out of Panipat of home furnishings. 2002, we ventured into the domestic market with our brand name Masper. And since then, we've opened our own company operated stores. And then we've opened our large format stores with Shoppers Stop, Home Center, At Home, Hometown. Then we have recently, just a couple of years back, we started the traditional dealer distribution network. And we have just started online also a couple of years back. That's a quick introduction about me, and I'll pass it on back to Naveen.
Sure. Next, Ayush Bansal, Director Liberty Group. To the best of my knowledge, has a strategic portfolio within the Liberty leadership. He's also an active leader and contributor to the entrepreneur community, both India and globally. Liberty, as we all know, has a legacy of over 50 years and are home to about 10 brands, if I'm not mistaken, that cater to the complete spectrum of customers across the landscape. Ayush, over to you.
Thank you, Naveen. Thanks for organizing this webinar today. It's great to meet a lot of the panelists and attendees today and understand more about the market, because we are all unaware about it. Everybody's learning at the same pace. About my brand, we are in the market from last 65 years, primarily into export and domestic. We try to cater to the entire footwear industry, be it institutional, retail distribution, also a lot into government tenders. So we do try to cover each aspect of footwear. Obviously, we have entered into e-commerce around four years back. We have a strong retail presence in India, some parts of South Asia. We have recently ventured out into Canada, Thailand, UK, and Middle East with our brand. So this is a little bit about us, and we'll talk more during the seminar. Over to you, Naveen.
Sure. Thanks. I'll move across to Kavita Malik, brand head at MiniClub. Our Niftian on the panel with deep expertise in product development, category management, core retail expertise over a decade with the likes of Pantaloon Lifestyle prior to MiniClub, which is arguably one of the fastest growing kids brands in the last decade. With a presence of over 600 MBOs and present in all large formats, in addition to all e-commerce channels. A one-stop shop for a very defined and specialized market of newborn to six-year-olds. Kavita?
Thank you so much, Naveen, for that wonderful introduction. Yes, we have been in kids, I think not recent, but I think ever since 2002. So our parent company is First Steps Babywear Private Limited. It's been established ever since 2002. It's almost going to be two decades that the company has been serving the manufacturing for all the newborn category worldwide. You pick up any of the best brands of Western worlds, First Steps Babywear has been serving them. Yes, MiniClub has been launched in the market in 2013. As rightly said, ever since we have just seen a good progression in terms of the acceptance of the product and the growth throughout Indian markets, be it online or offline. I think it's still, what we offer is very niche, but then it's the most fastest growing category in India. We serve 0 to 6 years of apparel and non-apparel solutions for all the babies and kids. And we do also have postpartum range for moms, for the new mommies across. So it's all technical garments. Yes, a lot of effort goes into it in terms of defining, making, progressing the products. But yes, it's still again what we compete with is the unorganized market in India. Hence, there's a lot of vast opportunity lies in terms of expanding the business going forward.
Great. Thanks a ton. And last but not the least, our co-host for this webinar, AdYogi, Rohin Mittal, a director at AdYogi, whose credentials, an interesting combination of a qualified CA and an ISB grad. AdYogi is a marketing automation product for e-commerce players that is integrated with most popular cart platforms across the world. Their strong partnerships with digital publishers help with deeper insights to deliver stronger performance marketing ROIs for businesses to scale their online point of sale. More to you, Rohit.
Thank you. Thank you for the introduction, Naveen. I hope everyone is good and safe in their houses. So I think just one difference from other panelists is that we are just 5 years old into the industry. And I heard Ayush about 65 years, Abhinav about more than 15 years, Kavita almost similar time, but what we have managed to do basically build a niche in the performance marketing space as AdYogi. And when I say performance marketing, it essentially means that whatever money you spend on your digital budget marketing efforts, every money is utilized to bring in more revenue on your website, either a higher revenue or an incremental revenue on the website. So that's what we've been doing. We are one of the top channel partners with Facebook, Google, TikTok in India. And we've been serving close to, as on date, close to 100 brands right now for both their national and international level of marketing. And we have some presence across the globe, few clients in the US, few clients in the Australian markets. And that's what we've been doing so far. And looking forward to getting getting started once the COVID post the lockdown ends. And let's see where the markets take us. Thank you. Over to you, Naveen.
Sure. Thanks. I'll also give a brief about myself to the attendees that joined now. So Green Honchos is a full stack e-commerce solutions company that integrates strategy, technology, customer experience to build and manage retail brands as partners online only. The key service areas for us are tech commerce platforms, the online branding part of the business, as well as the marketplace management. So I guess we'll move to the next stage. We're at 15 minutes past now, 10 minutes of introductions. Over to questions from our esteemed panelists. I think the first question is not as much business, but just as individuals. how tough have the last 45 days been to each of us, for each of you? Your individual thoughts. We can start with probably Abhinav, first to go.
It's a very tough question, you know. usually what happens, you have a routine to keep. So you get up in the morning and you leave for work. So I've been always, you know, me and my father have always been having this battle because I'm a lazy guy and he's the one who's always upkeep and he keeps me on my toes. So what we've been doing is, like, usually we get up in the morning, we've set up our times for having our internal meetings. So we've been keeping it as normal as we can. And we've tried to stay connected with each other, which is, you know, try to be, because we've always tried to be on the floor. I try to go onto the floor and I always like to be on the shop floor with my team. So I've tried to contact each and every team member and been on Zoom calls like this. So, and that's always kept us connected as an individual with our team. And that's what, I mean,
thanks.
What's really, I would say.
Yeah. Anyone else on the panel wants to take that question of how's it been the last 45 days in terms of experience? Ayush, you want to take it?
Yeah, I can go ahead.
Yeah.
So for me, I would not say it was tough. I would say it was, it is definitely once in a lifetime what we have seen. And this is what we will remember. I think I've self-discovered myself. I've done few courses online, read a lot of books, did my meditation, family time, you know, which we always complain. Nobody could complain. Now they want to throw us out of the house. So that's the situation. So I think that was amazing. In terms of SOP strategic planning, it was the best time. Every team member was available and we did all that groundwork, which gave us a head start. Definitely, we gave us a head start today. So we are all good to go full throttle, waiting for the markets, but company is ready to go. So that was, I think it was a good time, but this time should end now. Now the once in a lifetime should end and we have to all move ahead, waiting to sell. So I was happy in last 45 days.
Right, but I'm sure time to get back, right? So great. So, you know, I had the next question for probably Kavita and Rohin. Now that, you know, we are hearing and seeing things slowly emerge out of the lockdown, how is your immediate, you know, how do you see it panning out in the immediate 1 month time frame from a consumer or a demand standpoint, from what you've been hearing? Kavita, first to you, please.
Thanks, Naveen. That's a very good question.
In your segment, yeah.
Yes. So let me comment from the segment what we cater to. We have to understand this was a pandemic. It was just not a normal lockdown. Because it's not that today we have a national or a worldwide lockdown. We are not jumping into immediate starting of all the operations and everything. It will take time, and none of us can actually say how much time it will take to be, as in everything opening. I'm not just saying just to be normal. As they rightly answered the new normal questions before with the panelists, I would say that recently we just have seen two of the stores where they have been opening on high streets, definitely. As in the sale, a store which have done maybe, for example, if I have to just give you a number, that maybe they used to do 10,000 or 15,000 in a day from our counter. Suddenly they are doing almost 60,000 in a day. So I don't think so that will be ever since going to be the same. But yes, definitely there has been a huge gap in between now, where as in you know the birth rate of India, right? And that's not stopping any of the other pandemics happening. And if you read the newspaper, like as in yesterday, TOI says that post COVID-19, India will be booming in terms of the birth rate, which is going to be happening soon. So definitely there is a demand, but then the question is, how do we supply that demand? And where is that demand? Which ways are you going to fulfill that demand? Because your offline stores are shut and we are quite heavy in terms of our online offline expansion. And to our business currently, 15 to 20% is what was contributing the online. But again, you know, there's a loophole here again, or what do I say, that it's not being seen very adequately, that yes, the non-essential versus essential. So the essential products got the approval in terms of, you know, delivering across. But what do you say for a newborn, for the 12, for the first 3 months, 6 months or a year? Those garments, no, none of the parents talk, and they never know what time is the baby, you know what. So if at all any baby was born maybe in April 15, where do you get stuff for that? Definitely what I've seen is in the medical store, the primary requirement, be it a diaper or the food or the medicines, have been served. But then what about the other essential products? So it all caters to how well we have planned. But then foreseeing, definitely there's a demand. But then the question is, how do we provide that demand? Over to you,
Navin. Thanks. Great insights. So Rohin, I think, you know, we've discussed a lot. You know, we see it from another side because we work with a cross section of brands, you know, across segments as well. What has been Adyogi's experience in talking with how the first 30 days could probably pan out, or how do you see feedback?
I think in our opinion, what we've been talking to a lot of clients also is next 30 days are typically going to be a let's say a warm-up phase where a lot of brands will try and understand what things are open, what things are not open. Even after the government guidelines, there might be some challenges even with the delivery patterns in green zones and orange zones. Some of the government guidelines are not very clear whether warehouses can operate in red zones or containment zones. So I think next 30 days, what we are seeing is some activity to pick up, and that activity would range anywhere from a 20%, let's say, of a normal budget to 50% of normal budget. But the good part is that some of the brands, typically the essentials category and the premium category, super premium category, they have actually been doing quite well even during the COVID times, just because of either the aspirational product, people want to get a good deal out of those products. So I think hopefully after 30 days, because government is also banking on getting a lot of revenue from once the markets open up. So the assumption is that post 30 days, the online share should definitely improve. Some share of wallet should move from offline stores to online spendings. And brands are actually ramping up their online tech and delivery efficiencies to just make sure they capitalize as and when the moment the market opens up. So that is one. And I think once everything gets back to normal, there's a pent up demand as well, probably, which is getting accumulated. So the term which was used in China for revenge buying, that might come into force for the first 15, 20 days when the markets open up. And I think it's a good time to be prepared for that. Over to you.
Sure. Great. So one of the new normals really has been work from home for a lot of the companies, you know. So Abhinav, I'd like to take you on that. You know, something tells me that you've been very effective with getting employees work from home. So any thoughts on that as the real new normal?
Okay, so we have actually been, like I said, we've been having our regular meetings with our team members online, and I think we would be very happy because we implemented Microsoft Dynamics AX about 4 or 5 years back, and there's this app called Teams. So nobody in the office used to, you know, use this. But all of a sudden, last 40, 45 days, even if you set up a meeting, you don't even need to give them a call, and they are there at that time, even 2 minutes earlier. So that's one of the happiest things that's happened to us. And what we've done is, one of the success that we've been able to do is revamp our whole website. And that's happened, which is, kudos to the team, the way they've been working and really taken it forward. And now even with the post-opening, with the lockdown, we are really debating in our back office how many people really need to come in. And I don't see more than 10-15% people being in office or required there, because it saves them about 1.5-2 hours. So that's, you know, if they can utilize that at home and spend time with family, and they have better efficiencies. Unfortunately, on the retail front shop floor side, I wish something could have happened at that end also, but I don't see that happening.
Yeah. Right. So Ayush, I'll just pass this question on to you as well. You know, work from home. I think conceptually, none of us much believed into it. In the new normal, it definitely is one thing. I also hear from the industry that there's been a lot more communication now than there was when there was physical interactions. Are you seeing some of that too?
So for me, I would say work from home was very effective in last 40, 45 days. But as soon as the lockdown has ended, it has become ineffective. Because some staff is reporting, some is not. The challenge is to reach to the offices, factories. So I see a challenge there now in last 4-5 days. And I was maybe thinking of working from home for next 3 months so that, you know, everybody is clear that we have to work from home and we don't have a, because everybody feels safe being home. Working environment is very different and they have to fight their houses out to reach offices. You know, not everybody is that open about it. And I was just thinking on the fact that if we just stop close our offices and only get the billing staff, logistics staff and production teams to work and rest, if it could work from home for next 3 months, this should go out from us to our teams so that they have this clear in their head that this is how we have to proceed. I saw like the changes from last lockdown to post lockdown or the current situation. So this is what I felt, and definitely work from home I felt is more effective, more crisp meetings, results are faster. You don't waste time traveling because we have pan India global presence, and you know, it suddenly feels, why were we traveling so much, you know, for meetings, which were not required. So I think it's a great insight to most businesses, you know, how much retail, how much office space do we require? Such expensive office space, meeting rooms, you know, we go to Amazon and Flipkart offices and meeting rooms are always full because everybody is there to meet these guys, you know, why is it required? So that thought process is now started coming in. But definitely, I would say work from home is a very, very great tool to run businesses now.
Excellent thoughts there. So Rohan, I think it's interesting we hear that because, you know, from the other side of the service provider table, we'd love to make more closures without having to visit offices, right?
Yeah, absolutely, Naveen. So actually, it's a good time. A lot of brands are revisiting their strategies and re-evaluating that the scale that they want to hit, whether existing infrastructure and let's say the partners who are working with the brand, whether can they take them on a super aggressive path when the markets open. So we've had very good conversations with few brands. It's a good time. Brands have their own time, and it's actually good to sit and understand what kind of requirements they have and what kind of planning we have for them for the, let's say, next 12 months. So definitely a good period once we get busy with our own normal daily routine, and even closures are happening. So definitely good time to be on the other side of the table, but getting very impatient for now the business to start.
Sure. I'd like to steer the discussion, the next part of it, into the back end, which is, you know, so quite a few, this for you, Abhinav, I wanted to ask this question on the merchandising side. Quite a few brands have done quick experiments on repurposing their facilities and supply chain additions to product line. Do you see any product changes to your range pricing in the immediate time frame? I'm just asking more from the product perspective.
Two things. One that we're looking at is with the health, hygiene, and safety concerns, the kind of products that can be quickly turned around during this period. And second is with the existing products that are already there on the shop floor and what were to be coming in the next couple of months. So to answer the first part, there are certain introductions which we've done in certain product lines, like, you know, especially with hygiene, with like grooming kits, where we've made cutting sheets, because nobody would like to now share this at a, you know, if you're going for your grooming appointments. So we've done certain sets where we put together towels and, you know, cutting sheets. Then another product line where we see is, you know, the new mantra, which we see, I see a lot of happening is on Instagram, the new chef in me. So, you know, I've been seeing an N number of recipes which have been coming online and people entering their kitchens. So we launched certain product line back when we initiated the brand in India in the kitchen lines like pot holders, oven mitts, you know, gloves, kitchen towels and all. Now we see that being reintroduced because I definitely see that people will be spending more time at home. And especially with, you know, families which have domestic help, which are part-time. They will definitely, you know, refrain from having the part-time come in and take the initiative of going themselves in the kitchen.
Right.
So that is for the existing, it's for the new product lines. And for the existing product lines, yes, anything which was to be coming in, you know, for our autumn, winter, we've put that on hold as of now to see how the market reacts in these uncertain times in the next 3-4 months. And for our existing products, there would be certain offers where, you know, attraction from a brand like, you know, from Masco, I would say that, you know, we're not known to be on discount only. We're only known to be on discount on certain period of the year and never been on discount on our core products. So we would get in certain offers which would really attract consumers from a hygiene perspective to change their bed linen and, you know, towels. Because a lot of times at homes, people share towels for, you know, even within couples. Right. But now I am sure there's going to be, you know, we're doing certain monogramming on towels, which is going to be, you know, making sure that individuals use their individual towels and change them frequently.
Interesting. So Kavita, on the product side, I mean, I know that's your forte as well, but in a niche category, I wouldn't necessarily call it niche given the size of it now. Do you think it's too short term for making movements in the product line, or you'll have thoughts in that direction?
Naveen, to answer your question, as you know, when we come to the basic products of a newborn, I would like to say that 0 to 2 years, the product remains the same. It's again, which is supported by the Indian weather condition, which is almost 80% summer and 120% winter. So our basic product doesn't change. It remains the same. We already have a good amount in terms of what we need to offer when the post-lockdown is normal. Secondly, to follow with what we are adding to it is all the safety requirements, like all the masks. And in terms of the bits, so that will be used definitely, and that is what is being into the product lines. Rest assured, in terms of our second half of the season, as I said, our product is more anytime offering. So it's only the winter wear which we are concentrating, because yes, if you see, if it is a slight chilly or slight breeze or slight winters when it starts, parents always prefer the child to be first, you know, kept warm. So hence, winter wear definitely is just like how we are seeing the growth every time. So hence, there's no change in that. But yes, regular products, we do have a cycle of our regular offering, which we maintain going forward.
Great. That's very informative for the rest of us. So next, you know, I wanted to move a little more on the customer engagement and the loyalty part, because, you know, we also have a couple of brands with over 50 years of lineage here. So I'll definitely defer that question to Masper and Liberty. Engaging with customers is obviously the key. What are your plans to keep them connected in times of social distancing? Because a lot of your businesses are offline based. So if Ayush, you could go first, and then probably Abhinav on that.
Yes, Naveen. So definitely in these times when you are not in connect with the customer for so long, it's very important we are in touch with most of them. So what we have done is ensured that all our retail outlets, obviously we have the database of our customer base. So we made sure that they reached out to each and every customer, you know, just inquiring about the safety and health of all the family members. So this really, I think, played a very good role, because, you know, everybody is sending out the WhatsApp messages, but a phone call really made a big difference. by reaching out to each and every customer. So one thing which I think played a good role. Secondly, what we have done is obviously we have stopped or reduced our ad spend, but we have increased our spend on digital, and we are planning to increase it further in terms of social media presence, because that is the medium which is getting consumed the maximum today. And I feel it really reaches your customer well. These two things we have done, and I see a good positive sign, because when we opened up our outlets, we see customers reaching out to the managers with their small requirements of, the slippers or their sport shoes, you know, because this is the basic necessities. So which made a big difference at the start. So these two things we are doing.
Great. Abhinav, please your inputs on this.
Like I mentioned, what our team members, they've really done, pretty much what Ayush is saying, they have been in touch with consumers, because our product is a very high involvement product line, which is like home furnishings. So, ladies need, they need a lot of reassurance when they're looking at a product, and then involvement with our sales team members. Switching that to, like I mentioned, we revamped our complete website. So now we're trying to get into a space wherein, we know it's good times are uncertain in the next couple of months. We're trying to come up with certain virtual online store wherein we can actually give them the same experience, except for being that having that physical presence of them into our stores. So we're trying to, get our team to work on the virtual side to it. And also, where we will be doing a lot of concept, which we already do a lot of concept selling. So how we can do that interactive with our consumers over these calls online, and taking our product, in terms of mood boards, so that consumers, without coming into the stores, for instance, if you want to do your curtains, you want to do your bed linen, you want to do your bath linen, and you want everything to be coordinated based on your likes and dislikes, we can have our consultants can have interactions with them online, and then present to them online again the different mood boards, and then, physical samples, which can be smaller swatches. Sure. They can be sent across to them, and, they can make up their mind and all, and then based on that, take it forward.
Sure. Yeah, a more engaging process through the entire piece. Right. Yeah. So, Rohin, I think, from a tech and digital perspective, we do have a role to play in the loyalty side as well. Because often, I think, new age media like digital is blamed for only new customer acquisition. But, repeat customer acquisition, which is the lifeblood of, the economics. Any thoughts from a digital side on how, we could actually do much better in engaging consumers from a customer lifetime value?
Absolutely. So, what our take has been on this issue is that definitely sprinkle some budgets to reach out to your customers. Give them some recall of your brand. And customers are the lowest hanging fruits when the markets open up. So and data, a lot of data points prove that. So you'll be able to, let's say, get some insights on in what frequency are customers buying from you. If they've bought anything from you today, are they coming back to buy it in 30 days or 40 days or 60 days? Secondly, if you look at some kind of data, which we track for a lot of clients, then you'll understand that every rupee spent on your customer will give you a much higher ROI compared to every rupee spent on your newer audience. So if, let's say, brands are doing, let's say, 20-30% of their budgets, normal budgets on a monthly basis, then they should definitely keep engaged their customers, followed by their retargeting audience, because that's an audience which is interested in your product.
Right.
And probably move to a cold audience. And in fact, not just the ads, right? So there are a lot of other things that can be done. So push notifications can be rolled out in a very creative way. Some interesting content can be rolled out. Brands can be, very active in keeping their pages of Instagram and Facebook updated. And SMS emailer activities once in a while will cost very less for the brands. So those are the things, I think, which will keep that top of the mind recall for the brand. And once the markets open up, we'll also have some data points, as in which all people came to the website, let's say, more than twice or thrice during the lockdown. So why not reach out to them and then try and see if we can have a thing with them. So that becomes relevant in this time. And especially when online is going to be flooded, I think, and the markets open up, a lot of brands are gearing up to spend. Right. ROI, I don't see any reason for them to not scale up. So sure. Definitely must run.
Fair enough. So I'll come to you, Kavita. We're missing you on this for a bit. In terms of costs, you know, overall, it seems it's heading to be a tough year on the P&L with ever-changing dynamics. What would be your advice on how, you know, brands, retailers should plan? I know it's a large question, but if we had a quick snippet from you on that, any thoughts of how internally at Mini Club you're thinking about this?
$1 million question, Naveen. I would answer in three simple steps, not too elaborative. But then yes, cost at the back end, because you cannot do anything right now with in terms of the making of the product, but definitely the expenses which you're actually incurring in your corporate office and in your retail spaces. So in corporate office, definitely as in earlier discussion, Ayush and Abhinav have been saying that the work from home is actually working very successful. And I think that's the phenomena across where what we are actually experiencing. So yes, as what big MNCs does, like, you know, we are actually putting a norm in terms of work from home going forward. Hence, we're reducing the space of our operating corporate office. So that's one. Secondly, definitely we have to be, and we are, and we are going to be very, very conscious about our cash flows, because that's the lifeline of any business, I would say. So, and you know, the Indian market, the scenario is quite tough, from a minimum of 30 days to 45 days to maximum it expands to almost 120 days. That's where your receivables are really difficult and quite extended. So now, as per the new norm, I think we have to rotate the money quite fast. We have to make norms and discuss with all our partners wherever we are getting our receivables to coming down to almost 15 days. So that's the second thing what we are looking at. And thirdly, definitely about the inventory. Because again, coming from apparel industry, our inventory is the king, I would say, because that's what gets converted into cash, I think, for all the other industries too. But here, as much as now, you never know, because the situation has, you know, helped us learning so many things that now, earlier, if we were saying that, you know, we have to have n number of, or we basically in apparel, we say 100 days of NOD stock cover is what we maintain across. But I think we have to play a little more smarter, faster. That we, how do we bring down this to almost 60 days? So hence a lot of efficiency, not only in terms of manufacturing, but in terms of designing and getting the product on board. We have to adapt to it very normally. Like, okay. We might have learned about how Zara does 45 days of fashion into onto the floor. I think that's if you are getting most of your products into those line of scheme, that's where you will be able to change the game in your company.
Okay, thanks a ton. I'll move on to the next question, because probably we'll have to wrap up and open up for Q&A in about 5-7 minutes. So Ayush, this one's for you. We've probably spoken about this a bit earlier as well. Where do you see steep opportunity arising out of this situation in terms of segments, disruption, as you keenly watch and observe the industry, even from an entrepreneurship perspective, even globally?
So talking about our core business, which is footwear, what we are trying to do is try to understand the consumer behavior and make products which are friendly for the current situation, which is more hygiene, antibacterial, washable footwear, and getting that approved by the right authorities so that we can market it before anybody else gets into it. So this is, we have already been working, the D&D team has been putting in a lot of time and effort to get the products in place, because it's a lot of development which also needs to be done in China for the raw materials and getting the right certification. So that's a huge scope, because the scare in people is a lot to do with the footwear, because footwear is also a carrier of the virus. And what they need to do is that they need to make sure that they wash it like clothes. That's the new normal. If you talk about Africa, Africa has a routine of washing shoes every week. So they also wash leather footwear. So this is the trend which happens in most of Africa. But we're not used to washing leather footwear, but we need to start wearing footwear which is friendly, washable, antibacterial, which is a huge scope, I feel. And also open footwear as a category is doing, it should do better than the closed footwear. Apart from just this segment, we are not focusing to go too much into the masks and the basic products which everybody's entering.
Right.
We might do it as a freebie or not as a separate vertical. We don't want to go into that line as of now. But right. We are definitely using our manufacturing base to enter into bigger institutional government orders to get some business, which is not consumer driven, but it is purely for the turnover and the bottom line, what we are targeting.
Sure. Thanks a ton. So Abhinav, you know, I think we've had earlier discussions as well, but you know, we've at Green Oncho spent at least a significant focus of our time effort in the last year trying to figure out the new normals in terms of the technology, more in terms of retail. You know, omni-channel is an important aspect of utilization of inventory. But even omni-channel, a large use case is when customers are walking into stores and you're exposing, you know, inventory, which is virtual. We are also seeing a phenomenon of the reverse, which is a store to home. You'd have to take the store to the customer. How have you all been thinking about, because at Masper, I know for the last couple of years, we have been thinking about omni-channel, hyper-local, and any similar models that opens us up a little more. Your thoughts on that, please.
Well, I mean, again, coming back to what I said, working on our website, we are doing, you know, wherein touch and feel for our product is definitely, for a new customer, it's very important. For our existing customers, they do understand our range and then they are confident with it. So they don't have a problem and they order and then it just gets delivered to their doorstep. So, you know, with our physical stores, we do see customers are going to be limited who are going to be coming in. So what we're trying to do is you buy online and then you pick up from store, because a lot of times people will have this concern about, you know, the through and through of delivery hygiene from the person picking up the shipment to delivering it to the warehouse, to the consumer's doorstep. So they would, you know, like to pick up product from maybe an outside a store, outside a mall, outside. So those are things which we are trying to work on. That is where our mind is working. Second, like I mentioned, we would be, you know, with our online space, we would like to advertise wherein, you know, be 100% transparent with our consumers, where we would like to publish videos on how we have, you know, made sure that our factories right from, you know, our product, because we manufacture all our products from manufacturing all the way to retail, how the hygiene standards have been maintained. So that the consumer gets that confidence. And today, you know, why does somebody buy a brand? Is because they believe in the brand and they believe in the backward integration of the brand. So otherwise, I mean, buying a bedsheet from me or buying a bedsheet from any other brand, it's no, I mean, I'm sure nobody does an inferior quality of product. But the confidence level only comes through when, you know, I mean, we're talking about hygiene products, like let's say for bedsheet. We're trying to give a consumer a bedsheet which is going to be easy care.
Mm.
So, you know, washing a bedsheet frequently and then making sure ironing a 100% cotton bedsheet. So, you know, communicating that to our consumers is going to be utmost important for us. Yeah.
Rohin, I'll just come to you with that question and then a last rapid fire for everyone at the end. But you must be talking to a lot of clients who are looking to mobilize their inventory of their stores and make it more useful and seamless. Also, apart from an efficiency, it's cheaper to ship locally and it's also quicker, which makes a lot of sense in terms of customer gratification. What has been your observations at AdYogi in terms of these evolving models, apart from obvious e-commerce, but also omni-channel, hyper-local?
I think if you look at various trends of let's say the top brands who are at least working with AdYogi, One major indicator of how well you will do in terms of volumes is definitely a function of the catalog size as well. The moment, let's say, you are able to integrate through Omni all your stores' inventory on the website, there's always an 80-20 rule, right? Top 20% of your products will give you around 80% of the sales. So the moment you are able to expand that 20% bucket in absolute terms, you'll definitely be able to see much more efficiencies. And where, let's say, offline brands will probably have an edge over pure online brands is that they are located much nearer to the customers, right? Through their stores, through, let's say, a shop-in-shop. So it becomes really comfortable for an end user to go and buy the product either from a store, return it online, or let's say buy it on the online stuff and return it at the store, vice versa. So that happens. Secondly, one metric that a lot of retailers evaluate is the throughput rate, what kind of inventories they are holding and what kind of sales are they doing. So that number definitely with efficiency improves quite a lot, because brands in general who have implemented Omni are typically at upwards of a 98 or a 99% delivery rates within the first 24 to 48 hours. So there's a lot of untapped demand that comes in, which brands are able to serve at a very marginal cost. So I think that would be the next step for brands to adopt Omni and to implement across the stores, across the marketplaces, across the website. And the good part is that a lot of tech or a simplified tech with, let's say, experts like you help brands to kind of implement it quite fast, and it's seamless across the stores. So that will definitely have to be looked at as a low hanging fruit.
Thanks, Atan. I think that digitization enablement, I guess, it's the only obvious. So that runs into my last quick rapid fire question for each one. Couple of them. One is, if we look at last year as 100%, what would this financial year end at in terms of overall retail, not specific to any particular business or any particular company, but just overall retail market? 100% last year, what this financial year? And the second question is, I think the offline to online was about 96% to 4% overall in India. What do we think this financial year would be? So it's a bad question, but let's have fun with it, I guess. It's only a number. Ayush, first to you, please.
So in terms of retail, I don't want to comment anything right now. But in terms of our company, I can say that we should not drop our numbers more than 10% overall. In terms of the share of offline versus online, I would just compare it to our verticals, which do offline and online. It should go up by from today to around 15-20%.
Okay, great. Thanks. Abhinav?
Offline, online, we should be looking at about 15-18% contribution coming. And from last year to this year, the first quarter is already gone. So, it's just a guess for the number's sake. I think probably hitting 80%, 75-80% of what you did last year, I think you'll still make that.
Right. Great. Thanks. Kavita, I don't think Rohin and I need to answer that question, but you're the last one there.
Yeah, I would like to say that, Green Haunchers, who actually are the digital service provider for us, so it all depends on you, how well it will be built, the plan, and how well it will be executed. But yes, if last year was in terms of offline and online, online was almost 15-18%, we were actually benchmarking in the normal condition up to 25-30%. But yes, having said that, in this scenario, a parent will definitely not like to expose their kids to the outer environment. And our category as such is that the predominant buyer is the parent or the family members. So hence, we see there's a very good scope in terms of the online. But percentage, as I said, it all depends on you.
Right. Sure. I didn't expect a question back. I'll defer that to a session later, I guess. So just to all the 100+ participants that we've had patiently through this, please feel free. We'll open it up for Q&A right now. I already have questions, but I think there was one question directed specifically to Masper. So obviously I've been enough to answer that. One major challenge with online sales in India, the buyer market is not learned enough to read and understand product details correctly. Ladies need interaction with sales staff. How do we feel that gap is going to be addressed in the online sales model?
Like I said, the virtual space, which we will, you know, try to adapt, a lot of question and answers where we interact with our consumers and, you know, showcase videos to them, you know, trying to give them the technical jargon nobody's really interested in, but making sure giving them the gist of a product satisfying and, you know, is apt for their requirement is something we're going to keep it very simple, stupid is my answer. So that's how, you know, we would, you know, answer that question. I hope that answers the question.
Sure. Fair enough. So there's another question there, which is online presence and online selling. What's the change in plan like, Rohin? I think this would be to you. What would be the new focus points besides building up on sales and logistics on the ground? Questions more like, which social media platforms, which are more effective? Just some thoughts on that.
I think majorly what brands will have to evaluate is what kind of ROI they get on every rupee spent. So all the matrices will move from, let's say, either the branding campaigns or impressions to purely sales. What kind of revenues are they generating? And online will have to stand on its own knees. So online will have to be built up as a separate profitable vertical. And a lot of efficiencies will have to be built in. The good part with online is that there's a lot of data around it. You can actually understand what kind of PIN codes you're able to service efficiently, what kind of niche customer base you have, what kind of repeat rates do you have. So what we believe is very strongly that whatever is measurable can be improved. So a lot of matrices are there, which will probably help brands to understand what kind of industry benchmarks are there and where are they efficient or inefficient. Is there a scope to improve more? And I think the good part in online is every 6 months we see a new technology coming up. So I was on a call with Facebook earlier today, and exactly to the question what Abhinav just answered, what they are starting now is giving brands some access to WhatsApp. So when you select a product, then you can chat with somebody at the store level through the WhatsApp. So it's actually a mix of a digital selling as well as a human person who is salesperson who is trying to push through the WhatsApp. So those are the kind of things, and then something like artificial intelligence, which is Lenskart, is doing really well. So you can actually try on the specs on your face digitally, and then you can order the stuff. So I'm sure things will evolve pretty fast, but everything will be mapped to what kind of revenue it generates.
There's another question I think Ayush would best answer this, which is in the online, how do we feel brands would handle returns? Will we accept it? Will it change to being no returns? What does it look like?
So I think since the cash on delivery has been stopped, so these deliveries which will happen now are mostly already paid in advance, which will reduce the returns, in my opinion. The challenge today is the delivery at the locations and it getting delivered late, which might lead to increase in returns, which we haven't seen so far. So can't comment on that. But in a normal situation, if you deliver on time and there is no cash on delivery, the returns should reduce. As a brand, we haven't taken a decision of not to accept returns. It will be the same policy what we're doing earlier. Some protocols before receiving of sanitization and making the hygiene for safeguarding the warehouse, that has to be taken care of. I think otherwise it should not be a problem.
Fair enough. Thanks a ton. That probably answered that question. There's another one, probably another couple of minutes and we can look to wrap up, probably last couple of questions. The question was to me, but I think I'm not the best guy to answer it. But Hi Naveen would like to understand with perspective to offline, how stores are going to adhere to social distancing norms and sanitizing products, which is imperative. Abhinav, you'd like to take that up?
So that's one thing which is really going on in my mind. So, I mean, the first part, I'll answer it in two parts. One is the consumer coming into the store. And the second is once they touch the product, what are we going to do about that? So to answer the first part, our stores with our, you know, customers coming in, we have very limited footfalls coming into our stores. So definitely we are going to be, we are definitely going to be having limited customers into the store and maintaining that typically 6 feet distance. And I've already seen that not more than 2-3 customers are there at any given point of time in our stores. So that answers the social distancing norm. The second part in how you make sure that if somebody touches a product, how do you take care of that part? One, we would make sure that gloves are worn. And then second part is a customer would like to feel the fabric, so they definitely have to take them off. So if they were to touch a product, we have steam irons in the store. So we are trying to work out backward to see which chemicals are friendly to make sure that those products are steam ironed correctly and done again after a consumer is touching that product, so that, you know, that is, it's safe for somebody to walk into Masper and, you know, interact with the products and the stuff. Because you just walk around in our stores with our formats. They're not, you know, they're not behind the counter sales. So that's what.
Got it. Another question to Kavita. Do you think women would be interested in buying ethnic wear moving forward? It's a question I'll have to ask it.
See, I have been just studying about few of the markets, how the buying behavior has been so far. If you just pick up the example of UAE market right now, which is just open because of the Ramadan season currently. So the what the buying behavior over there is a lot in terms of the loungewear, a lot in terms of the house slippers, and a lot in terms of furnitures. Furniture, especially in terms of people working from home, they need to set up office-like space inside their living. So these are the few things which have been on a high peak, apart from the essential products. But then, yes, again, talking about the ethnic wear product, it depends. Like, you know, as in if earlier a lot of people used to go for social gatherings, but now post this lockdown, three things are going to be imperative and are going to stay for long. It's your social distancing, it's your usage of mask, and it's actually working from home and being at home. So in that case, it totally depends on usage of a person. Because any which ways, if you see over the past few years, ethnic wear was little on decline. Western wear was quite on high demand. The growth were of Western wear clothes were really high. But then yes, again, now if you're at home, more comfortable, what do you feel more comfortable in? Is it your loungewear or it's your ethnic wear? So it's totally subjected to the customer, I would say, and the demographics of India. So I leave up to that because, again, I won't be able to give any specific number right now.
Thank you so much, guys. There's a poll that is available for the attendees just to give feedback for the session. We're nearly done. I think one for Ayush. Marketplace businesses versus own website. There's a question out there. Within 30 seconds, any view?
I think marketplace will get a head start because of the general behavior of people going to their websites and comparing. And our customers are looking out for discounts. So that's the best place to go right now because everybody's looking towards economy, economic purchase and low ASPs. So I feel that will get a head start. But eventually, every brand has to focus on their own website and increase their market share. It should catch up in some time.
Okay, last word, co-host, marketplace versus website.
I think, so both are vertical channels of revenue. I think brands should definitely bank on both the revenues. But I second what Ayush has just said. Marketplace should start fastest because of the sheer scale and let's say the policy and the guidelines that they have. A lot of brands actually look up to what kind of practices are being followed by Myntra and Amazon to get replicated on the website. So, but website definitely in the long run gives a much more boost to the bottom line. What we've done with a lot of brands. So So both the channels will have to coexist, probably as a strategy where you get new customers from marketplace and then you get them shifted onto your website. But yes, brands need to work on both. There are customer segments who actually want to buy from the brand website just because maybe it's an exclusive collection or it's 100% authentic to buy from the brand store. So, my take.
Thank you so much, everyone. You've been a super panelist. Ayush, Abhinav, Kavita, Rohin. I'm sure it's very informative for all that attended and took the time out. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ayush. See you, Kavita. Thanks, Robin.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for hosting this.